Amen. We just want to prepare now for these children. We're going to take the young ladies first. And what we're going to do is that we're going to have a statement that we're going to pronounce when you go down under the water. Amen. This is what we say. In obedience to the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in Him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Now we have ministers here that will assist you. They're not going to let you drown. Don't get scared. Don't be fearful. The only thing, I'm not sure how cold the water is. How many used to cold water? Swimming pools. All right, we're going to, amen, get the ball rolling here. Take me to the water and baptize me. Hallelujah. We're going to ask the children, the young women, the female, to come to the back.
Take me to the water.
Obedience to the command of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
Take me to the water.
In obedience to the command of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in Him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Take me to the water.
In obedience to the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in Him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
In obedience to the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in Him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name.
Take me to the water.
To the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in Him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I've been baptized.
In obedience to the command of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord. I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
The commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
Commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
Take me to the water.
Commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith of him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
Take me to the water.
To the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
In the name of Jesus, I've been baptized.
In obedience to the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I've been baptized.
In obedience to the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
In the name of Jesus.
To the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
Take me to the water.
Of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes, yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Right.
obedience to the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus.
Hallelujah. Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
Take me to the water.
To the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name.
To the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name.
Take me to the water. Take me to the water.
To the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
In obedience to the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I've been baptized.
Oh, praise him. In obedience to the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
Take me to the water.
To the commands of our Lord Jesus Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name.
Take me to the water.
Christ, and upon your confession of faith in him as Savior and Lord, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost in Jesus' name. We will serve the communion, and since we have this table already prepared, we already know that Jesus is the one that this communion service is centered around. He has already borne our sins. Now, all of these children, now, y'all can take a, have y'all ever had it before? Praise God. So we're going to serve communion to all of the children. I guess we'll have enough. And all of the adults. Amen. Praise God.
Man, this is an exciting time to see so many young people get baptized. Hallelujah. Young people on fire for God. The communion is an amazing time. It's an opportunity for us to reflect on exactly what Jesus did. It's an opportunity to partake in who he was and who he is. Praise God. It's kind of like what just happened with this microphone. We just took the limits off. Amen. Praise God. And so if you have your Bibles, you can turn to 1 Corinthians chapter 11. And Jesus is talking to his disciples, and he's in the process of transition. And so we take his body, we take this wafer or this piece of bread, which represents his body that was broken for us, that we no longer have to be broken. Amen. Verse 24 says, and when he had given thanks, he broke it. That piece of bread there, he broke it. And it said, take, eat. This is my body, which is broken for you. He said, do this in remembrance of me. And so we're going to break that wafer now. And we're going to eat it. And it says, after the same manner also, he took the cup. That cup represents the blood of Jesus. That juice that's in that little cup, it represents the blood of Jesus, which was said for you for the remission of your sin. And so it says, when he had supped, saying, this cup is the New Testament. This cup represents a greater covenant. In my blood, this do ye as often as you drink. He says, do it in remembrance of me. If you go ahead and partake of that cup. And for as often as you eat this bread and drink this cup, you do show the Lord's death till he comes again. So let's take a moment to reflect. those who have some understanding of what Jesus had actually done for you at Calvary. Praise God. Praise God.
Understanding of their inheritance in you, Lord God. Give them a better understanding of their righteousness, that they're able to partake in your grace, Heavenly Father. Go to a new level in faith, Lord God, seeing the manifestations of your promises being prevalent and evident in their life, Lord God. We just give you alone all the glory, honor, and praise, and thank you for it. In Jesus' name, and all in agreement with that prayer says, amen. You all are dismissed.
In obedience to your command, upon the confession of your faith, my sister, we baptize you in the name of the Father, the name of the Son, the name of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Obedience to your command. Upon the confession of your faith, I baptize you in the name of the Father, name of the Son, name of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. obedience to your command. And upon the confession of your faith, we baptize you in the name of the Father, name of the Son, name of the Holy Spirit, Jesus' name. Hey! In obedience to your command, upon the confession of your faith, my sister, we baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Oh, 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 we praise you. Is that it?
Probably the person that mainly we are here, the reason why we are here, so he has to introduce, let everybody know how it happened and how we come to this point this evening that we're ready to baptize. And even today, you were instrumental in getting somebody here that really needed to be rededicated, and it was amazing today. Okay.
I was going to introduce myself, but everybody know. Well, it's been a rough, blessed month. Some of y'all know that I lost a very, very close dear friend to me who I've been talking to for years. Matter of fact, he's not even a friend, he's one of my brothers. And when he passed away, it hurt me deep in my heart because I was unsure about his status. And as a human being and as a brother, you know, it's a fine line between trying to judge somebody and letting God deal with them, because I don't know his exact status between him and God. That's his personal relationship with God. But I felt a pull on my heart that it's time to quit being shy and worried about stepping on toes. I'm just going to shoot it to people straight and real. Tomorrow's not promised, and it's time to go in and get to it. If this is what you're going to do, be about it. If you don't want to do that, then do what you do. You know, but Miss Nikita, Nana as we call her, is one of my adopted sisters. She's my other brother's girlfriend, Keontae, who's here with me today. Yeah. He a brother too. So, they together. So that's how I know her. I wouldn't know her if it wasn't for him. So, and I love him so much that it extends to her, you know what I'm saying? That's the type of love that our bond, our brotherhood is like that. We grew up as friends, but we brothers. And God is just moving, you know, the loss of our brother affect all of us deeply, you know what I'm saying? Because we wish we could have did something to intervene or stop what happened, but you know, sometimes when God calls you home, it's not always for nothing. It's always for something, because it struck all of us and put a spark in us to want to look at things more deeply, spiritually, you know what I'm saying? Been moving throughout all of us. When I say all of us, I mean like my core circle, my friends, my brothers, and their close ones to them. And it just struck a fire in me that's like I never felt before. I mean, I'm tuned in, and I'm, as y'all say, we're doing good deeds, but I say we're putting in work. That's my terminology. I'm gonna keep doing that. Because all my close loved ones, like Pastor Hill said today, I wanna see them. I don't wanna be there by myself without my homeboys. So, and it's just a blessing to see God working and moving and using all of us as a chain reaction. You know, it hits me, it hits him, it hits her, and it just spreads out like a beautiful virus. And just gotta let God keep working in us. And it's one thing to make a commitment, but it's another thing to go all the way in and take those extra steps and go ahead and get in that water and renew yourself. That is, it's beautiful. And some people don't look at it to that extreme like I do. To me, it's amazing, it's beautiful, you know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people don't get that chance, opportunity to right their wrongs or get on the right path. You know, life gets snuffed out quick. So you gotta be ready and be prepared and equipped with the Holy Spirit.
Okay, how did
Well, a few, what was it, like a few days or weeks after July 17th, and our brother passed away on July 8th. So after the dust had settled with getting him buried and everything, you know, it was still on our hearts, and I was talking to her, sharing some things with her on that day, and on that other day, the 17th, she called me, and I said, well, I'm at work right now. I'm working over, I get off at 6:30. I'm gonna come see you, because I really don't like, I'm not a phone talker. I'm a face-to-face person. So I went to talk to her, and I said, well, I'm on my way to prayer. You can come with me. And you know, I make that invitation to a lot of people, but she got up and she came. We came in and she walked in and I did what I normally do. I'm doing my little prayer and I introduced her and she had something heavy on her heart. And I think the presence was felt that she had something on her heart. And we prayed for her. And she made decisions on that day that changed her life. That commitment that she made on that day is the reason why we're here on this day. You know, when her daughter, Mimi, who's not here with us right now, she's visiting some of her other family, also got saved and baptized along with my daughters. So back to like that chain reaction, it's just spreading. Mimi got saved, filled with the Holy Spirit, and baptized in the water. You know, that was Mama's turn. Yeah, and I admire her for that. You know, a lot of people, they say one thing and they do something else. And she walking like she talking. Proud of you.
First, y'all know who I am. today is a lesson that for me. This is my first baptism. I've never been baptized before. I was really intrigued with Sammy's proposition. You know, it was something that I know I needed to do. You know, just for myself. You know. After seeing my daughter get baptized, it really made me want to change my life. It did. I know it's baby steps and, you know, everything doesn't happen overnight, but just the journey is what I'm looking forward to, the change. I don't know where life is going to take me after this, but I know it's good. And that's all I'm worried about. And thank you all for coming back from this morning so I can get baptized. Yeah. I can't make it to church on Sundays because I work 12-hour shifts. So I appreciate you guys for
right, that's good. She received the Holy Spirit last week, and Sister Denise and Sister Winston, is that right? Ministered with her. Amen. And I also wanted LaKendall will say something, because she, you know, I guess she stirred up too, because she had prayed a lot of the young kids through to the Holy Spirit. You know, I was shocked. I said, man, it seemed like she's been doing this for 20 years. Those little kids were falling out under the anointing, and she was laying hands on them. They were speaking in tongues. Boy, I'm telling you, it was really amazing. Say something, Crystal McKinley.
I was just as shocked as you.
Just a shock that all of her kids, you know, prayed in the spirit. So it's just really amazing. Blessed family. Amen. And Sister Kalila, we want you to have a word. You're here tonight, and you bowl, and you got a touch from, another touch from God. So we just wanted to hear from you.
I really feel like now it's not the time for me to give my full testimony. So just know that it's coming. And when it comes, y'all understand why I really want to say it now.
Yes.
But today really blessed me. And as always, Pastor said a lot that I had been dealing with. And, you know, just to speak the words to say, give me that burden. A lot of people don't know. I've been carrying that. So to see my family going through so much, and this whole week, it's really been a blessing because they've been calling me. And I thought that I wasn't preparing, but I guess with me, it's just the Precious connecting. And when I'm not able to be here, just me doing what I know to do, God, he orchestrates things in a way that we'll never understand. And the enemy, he throw everything at you that he know to throw at you to just distract you, get you off course, to get you discouraged, all that. And it's not always easy to not even beat your own self up, you know, or to just feel like you being your worst enemy, just holding things back that I know that I want to do, but just allowing God to use me in the way that I know he can and he wants to use me, because Saturday is my birthday. So just me rededicating my life today, God has been dealing with me ever since my mom passed away and dealing with my family. And he just been putting this word in my spirit, rebirth. And so even with the harvest time classes coming up, when I received my packet, y'all just don't know how I felt. Because it's on my birthday, and just that word that he's been putting in me. So I said, okay, Lord, I know, I hear you, I see you, you moving, you working. You know, and my cousins, my auntie, they've been calling me, and most of my days I'm on the phone, and I'm ministering to them, and while I'm ministering to them, I'm ministering to me, and it's just been amazing. I've been able to take my mind off of me, and just pray and focus on them. And it blessed me. It's just been building me up. So even when I called and I asked Irene, I said, well, just pray for my family. I see God working and I see him moving, and even my kids. Because Amina, that energy, mama trying to keep up, but it's not easy. And I'm thinking like, okay, I felt like I had this when I had Aunt Janae, but I was like way younger. So now it's just different for me. But she's in school now, things is changing, just the way she sing at home, and people don't know how she sing at home. So I know that those things that she see me doing, she do. So God, he's moving and he's working. So like I said, it's just really not time for me to give my full testimony, but when it's time, I promise y'all I'm gonna do that. And y'all, you'll see. So just keep praying for me, keep praying for my family. And I'm going to just try to stay committed and just do what it is that I know that God has placed in my heart for me to do. So that's it.
All right. Well, we better take me to the one. Praise God. Okay, we're glad for your friend in the back. Seems like such a nice guy. You been out of town, is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah, amen. Praise God. Well, we look forward to. Yeah, okay. Well, you ready to get baptized? You might as well. Just receive the Lord. All I have to do is just pray with you. You be ready, okay? You don't mind going back wet, do you? Okay, come on, man. come on. Praise God. Yeah, you know, Jesus has already... but anyway, it's just a matter of our receiving Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. And He's done a lot. He suffered, died, went to the cross, and He suffered 3 days just to release us from that penalty. If He had done that, then we would have to pay our own penalty when we face God. I mean, when we face, you know, after death. But Jesus bore your sins. He became sin, and He took the punishment that we should have taken, and those that don't receive Jesus will take the punishment. Amen. So that's the good news. God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him shall not perish but have everlasting life. Usually when you hear different ones give their testimony on how the Lord changed their life, usually that's enough conviction for you to accept and to receive Jesus, because what He did for them, you know, He'll do for you. He loves you a whole lot. He's not willing that any would perish. And we know that there's so many things out there, so many traps and schemes and plots. The enemy is pulling on people to take them out. And your life is just in a real risky position without Jesus being in it and being the Lord of your life. Because when He comes in, He kind of takes over and begins to care for you, lead and guide, and to give you that joy, the peace, only that He can give. So we just want to pray with you, and the Bible mentions that if you would confess with your mouth, Jesus, I believe with all of my heart that You died for my sins. You know, most churches have taught this for many years. Jesus died on a cross, and He was buried, and He rose again. And that's the reason why we celebrate Easter. But that is the exact thing. I believe that Jesus died for me to save me from a burning hell and from a lake of fire, from an eternity forever separated from God. I believe that He died for me, and He bore all of my sins so I don't have to die and go there and bear those sins in my spirit and in my soul when I leave this earth. Amen. If you believe that with all of your heart, that Jesus did it for you, He paid the price, He paid it all, and that after He paid the price, He rose again. When He rose again and ascended to the Father, that was the Father saying, well, the sacrifice You made, the price You paid, and all of Your sufferings and punishment that You did for the human race is sufficient to release you and me and everybody from sin. So when we say, Jesus, come into my life, forgive me of all of my sins, and I make You Lord of my life, amen, then Jesus will come in. Satan's power, your old life pass away. Satan's hold on your life will break, and Jesus will come in and make you that new person. Joy and peace. And you feel the assurance that if anything happens to me, I've accepted Jesus as my Lord and Savior, and everything will be all right. So we're just going to pray. Everybody to stand with us, and let's agree. Amen. I just want, your first name is what?
Keontae.
Keontae. Okay. This is what you said. Jesus, I thank you for dying on that cross and taking my sins away. I believe that you are my Lord and my Savior. You paid the price for me so that I won't have to suffer in hell and forever in the lake of fire, because you have been to hell and paid the price for me. And I thank you for settling that debt and rising again from the dead. And I receive you now in my soul, in my heart, as my Lord, as my Savior. Take away all of my sins, blot out all of my transgressions, and receive me into your kingdom as your own. Thank you, Lord. I believe that you have heard my prayer, and I want to be baptized in water, which signifies that there has been a change in my life. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Amen. Let's praise God for his salvation. All right. Okay. We're going to. Amen. Okay. Are we ready? Take me to the water. Take me to the water. Take me to the water and baptize me in obedience to the command and to those that have established and placed their faith in Jesus. We now baptize you in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, and in the name of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Take me to the water. Take me to the water and baptize me. Praise God. All right. In obedience to your command and upon the confession of your faith, we baptize you, my sister, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Take me to the water. Take me to the water. Take me to the water and baptize me. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Yes. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord. Okay, hallelujah. All right, praise God. All right, hallelujah. All right, the Bible says that repent ye and be baptized in the name of Jesus for the remission of your sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. This is one instant in which the Holy Ghost, receiving of the Holy Ghost, will follow baptism. In many instances, the salvation and the Holy Spirit come simultaneously or before baptism, but it doesn't matter what order it happens. Amen. Upon the obedience to God's command, and upon the confession of your faith, we baptize you, my brother, in the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Ghost, in Jesus' name. Amen. Take me to the water. Take me to the water. Take me to the water and baptize me. Hallelujah. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Anybody else want to go down? the babies want to go down again. A little something. Yeah. That was in the plan of God. Amen. All right, while we dismiss now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his presence with exceeding great joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, honor, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Everybody said, praise the Lord. Amen. Thank everybody for coming back to support these that were baptized. We only had one candidate confirmed, and so we ended up getting two others. Amen. And even Sammy went to go back. It was so exciting. Yes, little Sammy.